any time to really, or fast enough to deal with an Alchemist.
Yeah. I feel like Monkey King might put, like, instill a little bit of fear to picking Morphling, right? Just because of how much you can move around.
Yeah, Monkey King's super strong in lane, so I would be worried about IGV picking weak laners and not being able to apply any kind of pressure versus the Alchemist. But
Juggernaut, they go further.
Juggernaut, Earth Spirit, some really strong lane pressure. You can definitely pressure Alchemist between like levels 1 to 4. Mm-hmm. I think once Alchemist is level 5, he doesn't really have to lane anymore if he doesn't want to. He just kind of retreats to that jungle, farm up with the Iron Talon.
Gives them, like, if they want as well, they can do like the Batrider Earth Spirit, like force experience in the offlane. Same thing, like strong lane. Put pressure.
Vengeful Spirit is such a miserable zoning hero.
Oh, yeah. And versus Batrider, your turn rate's miserable.
You can't do anything against Batrider, and if an Earth Spirit rolls on top of you too, you're most likely going to die. And
so the Weaver does come out.
The
good
Weaver,
call.
Man. Nice.
Yeah,
nice.
With the Alchemist too, so the Aghanims as well, it makes it pretty ridiculous versus Batrider.
Yeah,
always be able to Weaver.
They'll
like,
have Venge Swap, yeah. And they'll have potentially the Weaver Aghs to save Alchemist as you siege those buildings.
And they have a lot of minus armor.
Yeah.
That was like crazy to watch earlier. No-tail on the Vengeful Spirit with the Aghanim's upgrade. Just constantly Alchemist goes in with Chemical Rage, smacks the tower a couple times. They go on out, swaps them out. Yep. Heals the full with Rage and Warlock heal. So really cool kind of Ag's strategy usage there.
Okay, so maybe go back for the Weaver.
Yep. Big fan of that pick. Like it a lot. He's going to be able to lane up against that Batrider solo and allow Venge to, he doesn't have to have the biggest impact in the laning phase.
All right, so how is IG Vitality going to deal with this? Because what I'm hearing is Newbie is winning this draft.
Oh, well, they should pick their other support hero now. We'll see a position 5 for Super. I think that they could... Disruptor
is pretty decent.
It's okay. Vengeful Spirit, I think, has always been a nice hero against Disruptor because you can just swap someone out of the ultimate.
Tend to favor the,
they go for it
the
anyway.
CM, but they are going to go for the Disruptor.
But it's going to help them in teamfights. It's going to give them some lockdown for Weaver. It's not a bad tool for hunting down the Monkey King.
More team fight.
Yeah, it's good. It's a solid pick. They're definitely winning in the team fight department. If Batrider manages to get a lasso on somebody and Vengeful Spirit isn't close enough to swap, team fights will most likely go in IGV's favor, considering the farm is relatively even.
Yeah.
All right, so what do those last heroes need to
looking
do?
For an offlane for KPII and a mid or a carry for IGV. I would most likely guess that Juggernaut's going to go mid. Up against the Alchemist is a pretty good matchup for him.
Yeah.
With our Spirit as well, yeah.
So they'll get a last pick up here against Weaver. I'm not sure what they would take. It's there's not like, I mean, what do you think are some like heroes that you would want to play as a carry against a Weaver?
I was thinking they might actually go for the OD, but it actually does get banned out. Just to be, if they did decide to go for the Jug, but other carry heroes.
That's true. They could also just put Juggernaut in the safe lane and do a different mid hero.
Anything that particular
nothing really stands
pairs
out.
Up nicely
we could,
against
I mean, we could still see the Morphling. It's not awful. I mean, it's pretty decent against Weaver. You get a lot of burst damage with E-Blade. But
feels like it's not aggressive enough somehow.
I'd just be a little worried for the lane. That's all. Like Disruptor, Morph, or Spirit. I guess it's
absolutely.
Yeah.
Definitely a concern.
It's a little bit weak. If they do want to go for that, but
there's a couple times I've seen in the drafts, especially today, is like the team with the last pick really just doesn't have like a great last pick hero.
Yeah, we saw like IG just like we're like, all right, we're gonna pick the Lifestealer, and it's like we're versus Naga with and TA as Lifestealer. It's just like they felt kind of like forced because there was not really any better real options.
Surely there's good options for KP still.
For KP, yeah, cool. I mean there's still
he's gonna have
of
last pick.
Off-laners.
So Sand King banned out. I believe we still have a center in the pool if he wants to.
Yeah, some more lockdown for Newbie would definitely be nice.
Yeah.
Ooh, nah, he wouldn't. But Omni Knight would be cool.
I feel like no one's touching that hero. He's like,
he's an alright Midas hero. He's got an experience gain, doesn't he?
He does have an experience gain talent.
But he's not super strong. And I've seen a couple of Monkey King drafts that really struggle with initiation. Mm-hmm. So I really like when the three position is playing a Centaur or a Sand King or a Slardar or something.
Oh, that's a new one, but that's also could be the matchup versus the Alchemist. That's something to
deal with. I think that's most likely
it.
The matchup versus the Alchemist.
Yeah. Good versus Monkey King as well. Go for the catch. Gives him more fight, more burst.
That's a nice and cool pick. I mean, I wasn't exactly sure what they would pick there, so kind of doing something a little bit different than most teams and kind of stepping outside of the box is really cool to see. Timbersaw is a an awesome hero to watch.
And get the slaughter.
It works well with Batrider too, because they were kind of lacking burst inside of the Batrider Lash. So they have like Omni Slash, but now Timber gives them that nice like burst to be able to bring someone down quickly.
A lot of damage, some semi carry. He does a lot of damage against Weaver, and he can also deal with the Alchemist Illusions.
Yeah.
I still favor newbie.
It was
I still
say, favor newbie.
My prediction's newbie for sure.
Yeah. Really? So you're that? No problem at all with it.
I think they're the better team, and I think they have a really solid draft that totally fits in the meta. I think Slardar offlane is a little questionable, but this is a China versus China game. The meta is always different than everything else.
Okay, so newbie for Peter. Fogged, which way?
I'm going to also side with newbie. I like their amount of like the Minus Armor they have built up as well. They have good tower pressure. We mentioned the Ags for like the Weaver as well. For the Alchemist, I think they're going to be able to siege pretty well. I think in July is probably going to have a bit of a rough game.
Okay, are we getting 3 out of 3 here?
Yeah, you are. Yeah, okay. I'm going for newbie as well, I think. Yeah. They have the. I think they have the better draft, and they are the better team.
Hmm. Okay. Fairly brewing predictions up here on the analyst panel, so it happens from time to time. And whatever we do, we are going to have our first game just around the corner. Let's go back to our commentary team. They've changed things up down there as well. It's now Malini and Toby One. It's all yours, boys.
Thanks, Red. Don't worry, it's boring up there at the panel. We've got Malini down here.
I'm with IGV.
I think you're with IGV?
Newbie have drunk too much of the Alchemist Kool-Aid. Okay, and now they're like, oh, man, Alchemist is unbeatable.
We were always wondering what was in that concoction. It was Kool-Aid and something else. Yeah, but it looked good. Like, the Timbersaw pickup came in. It's like, okay, well, maybe this matchup, it's not what you're expecting to come up. We're talking, like, Ember Spirits, talking about these.
I hope Paparazzi's playing it, though. But I don't think he will be.
Well, just because you want to have the SC and Paparazzi, like, marriage lane back together again.
I think Timbersaw has a much higher skill cap than Juggernaut, too. So you want your best player playing the hardest hero.
One way to look at it, man. Yeah. I can't wait to look into the game as we're going to head in and see how it's all going to roll out. The Slaughter was the last pickup from newbie.
Oh, it is Paparazzi on the Timbersaw.
It is?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's going to happen.
This is good.
We're probably more excited about this because we got to cast that 1v1 matchup, and it was such a beautiful time. That Puck versus Puck matchup. We're just going to keep the camera on mid only from now on out.
Change that carry to mid. Change that mid to carry. Things have changed. Paparazzi has inspired his team.
Flexibility
I'm
is
the
there.
Best mid in the world. Let me go mid, guys. You can't say no to that.
Yeah.
Can't say no, you aren't.
I've got a trophy and a check to prove it, boys. Like, you have to let me go in there. At the same time, the rest of the IGV lineup was like, we were telling you what to do the entire time, helping you to win this one.
It's also, I also think that Paparazzi probably suggested this hero. Because they're like, okay, Paparazzi, do you want to go mid? It's like, oh yeah, sure, I can own this elk with, what do you want, Timbersaw. Oh, okay.
What a surprise with aggressive maneuvering. It is going to be the Monkey King bouncing himself around, trying to find a quick little jump in. So Kaka on the tree line. Dogfights will walk in range. It's a rolling boulder forward. There's your first on from Faith. KP, follow-up crush, a little bit too far away from it now. Goes for the crush, but it's only on Sakata, who's able to just fall back, and we go back towards the rune. So aggressive maneuver, but no joy really coming from it. Not for newbie at least, but they are going to commit themselves in to running this three-man offlane. And we get the we get the mid. Paparazzi versus SC. SC's got a point to prove with this lane down.
That's a pretty easy lane for Timber. Very easy. You want high armor hero mid. You occasionally see Terror Blade mid versus Alchemist just because you don't take any damage from the Acid Spray and Reactive very similar.
Dogfight's clipped himself for the moment. Kaka wants to keep him there, so he's going to jump in and try and man mode this. With the help of Fate, they may just have enough damage, but it's Hill on Hill who really is the king. Dogfight with a very fire committal. It's going to be Dogfight taking the first blood. A full-on fight. Fate does not have enough mana for another stun just yet. KP, if you can keep the distance in close, even then, there goes your crush. Keep the vision around the tree line. Go out into the tower. TP support's coming in from the Earth Spirit, but KP will pick up a double kill on the offlane, but it's not going to stop there. Dogfights rolling boulders forward, and Faith, Sakata, he actually cut his way through the tree line. KP has to commit the mango to get the crush off and keep that Juggernaut away. He's able to do so.
That's actually really unfortunate for the Monkey King. He has poor man shield. He should easily win that man fight, but he had the trolls right-clicking him the whole time. And they buffed the damage type of the troll. I think if it were the old piercing damage, he would have lived easily. So that is, that's not good for old Monkey King, but they are still 2 kills up.
Yeah, 2 kills up for newbie and money going into KP. So he'll be able to afford his boots nice and early.
Dogfights, is he gonna try and steal this bounty rune? Alchemist
2 minutes in.
I think they're looking back up towards the top lane for a fight. He's going to roam in through the back, and there's only two. It's two on three this time around, but Dogfight doesn't really have the positioning. He left the observe ward a little bit further down, and yeah, he's going to rolling boulder forward and take the bounty rune.
Yeah, you got to prevent Alk from getting all these bounty runes. It looks like Monkey King is headed down bottom. Is he just going to sit there and wait for the bounty rune? That's going to be a long wait for him. So they don't even give Alk any of the bounty runes, and he has a tough matchup in the mid lane.
SC is 100% focused on staying in the mid with Paparazzi.
SC has 13-5 to 6-1. Looks like our 1v1s yesterday.
How do you even stop it? Like, maybe this is one way to do it. The Stack, Monkey King's farm, going for a roam. He's looking for potentially the courier. But Paparazzi is waiting as long as he can. That courier is just sitting in front of the tier 3 tower, not budging an inch. It's got the boots. Nothing else on it, but it needs another 20 seconds before she can fly.
The thing is, he doesn't even need any items on the Timber Saw. You can just own with just a poor man's shield.
It's like, let me fly out regeneration. Oh, wait, no, there's reactive armor, which makes me more powerful than anything.
Alchemist Kool-Aid, man. So they are stacking. That's what you need to do. It's going to be a really rough lane, so SEC is stacking himself. We see Faith and KP on the left side also stacking. And they probably need to start feeding him TP scroll so he can double bounty as well. You'll see that pretty commonly Alchemist gets the bottom one, TP's at the top shrine, gets the other one, and then proceeds to do his stacks with his soul ring and whatnot. Mm-hmm. Alchemist actually committing for a poor man shield quite early, too. That's not...
This is the only way to get the farm back, right? He has to go into the jungle to do it.
Yeah.
You mean that, like, that over Iron Talon?
No, that over Stout into Iron Talon, because he doesn't have that much gold to work with.
And so he goes for both. Looks like a top bounty rune, a little bit of an issue for KP on the run. Dogfights and Super, the kick will be perfect, and KP, not enough life to survive that. So good rotation in from IGV.
They're
able to find him.
They're already controlling a pretty good area of the map right now. Like, that top bounty is not safe at all, and they have no vision up there. Slaughter doesn't even feel that safe jungling in that area.
The only lane which is currently working is the bottom lane for Newbie, and that's 22-8. So the CS is good for the Weaver. If the Alchemist can play catch-up and the Weaver gets big, potentially gets funneled an Aghanim set to 2, then you do have that other issue of IGV. Like, you focus down one target and then anyone can be time-lapsed.
I'm worried about him just being able to get a Radiance, let alone Axe.
Yeah, I'm thinking too far ahead for you.
And now he's trying to get top bounty rune. Isn't going to be able to sweep at SCCC. It runs right into Injuli.
Yeah, they're battling top lane. That's where KP's going to fall down again.
He's already forced to pop his haste. At least he will get one, but... it's not looking that great. I think Weaver is good versus Bat, but it's terrible versus Earth Spirit and not good versus Disruptor.
The Sentry was just an inch too far away. They threw down. Actually, no, it's not. It's actually going to be on it. I just thought with the pounce up, he did it for the Observer Ward. But IGV may have actually scanned that Observer Ward as opposed before they dewarded the Obs of Dire.
Dude, what is that gear looking Observer Ward? I don't think I've seen that before. I'm a cosmetics guy. Sad thing is, I think I care more about cosmetics in game than in real life. I'm like the antithesis of Charlie.
But you also, you know, you dress up.
Yeah, I dress up.
You balance life and in game.
One of my favorite things from TIA, last TIA, was when they called him Evil. It's like, oh yeah, he could be a mob boss.
Oh, Paparazzi, really? He's getting up in the face of KP, and he knows he can.
They cannot deal with Timber at all. Amplify is okay, but he's gonna have max reactives quite soon. He actually went for a more offensive build too with the two in Whirling Death, not the 113 that is so commonly seen. Because no one's really gonna be pressuring him. He needs to be able to kill the Alchemist, and having that extra point for that pure damage is quite important versus Chemical Rage.
Yeah, and I'm watching like KP cutting away those trees in the mid. It's like he's waiting for the Timber Chain to come forward, so the only way he can stand in close is to make sure he doesn't get caught in that Timber Chain of Paparazzi.
And Paparazzi can also chop down a lot of trees against the Monkey King.
Mm-hmm.
Natural enemies.
And you get the Flying Vision against the Monkey King from the Batrider, plus the Kicking which comes in from the Earth Spirit. So yeah, this shouldn't be an easy Monkey King game.
No trees will be spared.
Greenpeace will have many complaints about this match.
All they're missing is like Iron Talon plus Battle Fury plus Iron Talon on the jug.
All right, jump forward in July. Just hanging around a little bit longer. With the Scarab Beetles, Injuli's going to lose a lot of his armor, but they need the slow, they need the extra stun, and Kaka, he'll provide if it's a little too late, especially when Newbie, Kaka and U9 having to run through the Firefly. So like U9 already triggers off his time-lapse and gets back.
When Napalm was enough to dissuade them, Napalm's still very difficult to deal with.
KP's having to come back up to this top lane. The T1 towers have been brought down. The wave of Terrakion Leaf pulled the creep wave off the tower a little bit, but the damage has been done from IGV. 7 minutes in, you already have that top tower down to 1/3 of his HP.
Get that Aquila and start pushing.
Well, we already have it on the Juggernaut.
Yep. It's a good plan. Shut down Alk's jungle, steal stacks if you can, prevent access to at least one of the bounty runes, and most importantly, take T1s.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that fear I had as well for Newbie's Observer Ward, like it was already de-warded out, and IGV
boots.
Already keep their own Observer Ward up, watching for Alchemist to back out and start farming again.
Dude, the phase boost is very interesting on Alk.
Is he? Do you just go? He's going armlet straight away. Like so. Like obviously, that's nothing unusual. But does he still go? Like, is Radiant still the play here, or do you build almost like a more combat style alchemist if he's going to go phase boots, or is phase boots just ST's way of keeping his distance from paparazzi?
It might just be. You'll see Medusas get phase boots, and Trez generally do more damage in team fights. But phase is really nice for traveling in between camps. Which is definitely not to be underrated. And it's not like Alchemist is going to be like, oh man, I got to sell this gold, sell this later. My 1,500 gold investment, I'm going to lose so much out on. That doesn't happen with Alchemist. So I think it's actually not even that much. It's like, what, 1,300, 1,200 gold? So, yeah, I think it's
that's nothing for an
good
Alchemist.
It is nothing. But if you think you're going to get your BOTs really late, you'll get a lot of value out of the phase boots. So I think it's nice that he's not going full greed. Although, as I say that, he has max greed this group.
Well, enough that he's able to capitalize it. And IG's not really pressuring him any more than just having a really good laning phase. So IG are happy to accept the status quo. They're going to bring down this T1 tower, and that's probably when we'll start to see IGV's movement, where the priority comes for them. Because you've still got U9 farming up in that bottom lane. He's not looking too terrible on money. Like, he's 500 net worth sitting behind the Juggernaut, which is his opposite one. And now that distance will be increased slightly with Larson on the tower.
And Batrider is getting a lot more than his counterpart. That is the only core matchup that we see kind of out of whack.
The blink versus blink timings.
Yep. And he doesn't have to get the Iron Talon that the Slaughter has to invest in. KP not even going for the Tranquils.
At least goes for this one as a nice little maneuver. Uses the Iron Talon, take the aggro on the creep wave. The Radiant Scan will actually scan the movement of IGV coming off the top lane and into the mid. So IGV definitely want to really shut this down. If they can take both these T1 towers before the 10-minute mark, Alchemist is going to start to get throttled up. But the movement's coming over from Newbie. All five heroes converging on the mid. They should have fortification. Now Kaka jumping in for the stun. He won't really hit on anybody. He actually throws the stun, connecting on Dogfights, who's up on top of the hill. But it's Sakata who's going to be the one to go down. Trying to spin underneath the tower, Nubu will end up denying the mid T1 tower as well.
Swap was used, and a lot of space created for Injuli. Injuli very close to his Blink Dagger timing, just 150 gold. He was not present in that fight, and for good reason. And now is where things start to get a little bit more heated for Nubu. How do they actually stave off this Earth Spirit, this Batrider, who are surely just going to smoke up and try to take control of the jungle with the Timbersaw just being that big, fat machine in the lanes that is unkillable?
It's the ultimate question. It's the reason why Slaughter is here. It's the reason why Newbie have to be really on point for their positioning. And a lot of that's probably going to come through vision. See these ganks coming in from Invictus Gaming. But at the moment, IGV, again, their wards still hold beautifully. So they watch both of the bottom runes. They have eyes into the mouth of the Roshan pit. And any heavy lane rotation should also be scattered out by just those two observe wards they have on the river.
And they have three heroes mid just like looking at the Timbersaw. It's like, I know you're here, but we cannot kill you at all. Please go away now.
You do. Interrupt Timber Chain. Like.
Lasso on the bottom lane. KP gets slaughtered by Juggernaut. Oh my god. I don't know if they needed to use Omni Slash there, but that was the blink reveal. And KP is probably like, oh crap, he has blink already. Things are not looking good.
The fact there was also no reaction from Newbie scouts at the fact of what we're watching, which was Newbie smoking up towards the top lane, but pouncing over the tree lines. Should be able to reveal, in fact, it does now reveal Dogfight, so the quick stun into the second with the jump down, and U9 able to get the last on that. So with the creep wave coming up towards the tower, Newbie can do a little bit of tower damage back the other way, but then having a lot of damage done to the T1 tower on bottom lane, while Paparazzi still controls the mid. And in fact, they will be losing that T1 tower on bottom lane.
SCCC was trying to farm up that Ancients, but he's actually quite scared. That is not a safe place for him to farm. Like, what camps can they realistically farm without fear of dying right now? It's just very, very few. And now they're trying to open up the Dire Jungle, which I think is a very important move by Newbie.
Una is also, he actually needs to hang around here. They need the gold from the tower. Denying up the catapult's not really going to work because the tower's already within deny range, and okay, they'll have to let it go. Yet again, another tower being denied up.
Yeah, so now the general move is to swap jungles. You get Alchemist to farm in the opposite lane, and then you kind of have just supports Leech. But IGV are unrelenting when it comes to pushing down these T2s. Sakata is just still beating on this T2 with no response from Newbie.
Nope. But what are they meant to do? Unai is not ready to fight. Alchemist isn't ready to fight. Until that radiance is up, he doesn't want to be involved in engagement. So it's on Kaka, who's able to get the initial stun. Now the jump forward, the Beatles are coming in, but they're not really going to hit on anyone. In fact, in July, swap back out, and the Wukong's command from Kaka, it just creates a space. IGV cannot get close enough to help out that Batrider, so they accept the fate. He goes down, U9 finds himself yet another kill.
Sentry Ward was placed a tiny bit too late. It does see the Observer Ward, but it was only after he got Boundless struck. So Alchemist, quest for Radiance, maybe what? 3, 4, 5 minutes at this pace, depending on bounty runes and stacks and whatnot. And looks like they haven't been able to ward any of the camps. So this is pretty important for Newbie, that IGV don't actually have vision. They have to smoke or scan or move together as a big pack in order to identify this Alchemist. And it looks like they are going to start smoking right now. In July, it does TP up. They are 4 men at the shrine. And boom, let's find Alchemist. Yep.
The Observer Ward already saw him, so they headed directly towards the Ancients. Thanks to the fact that Alchemist didn't actually stack the Ancients. Actually, no, he did actually get the stack off. But he doesn't stick around for the fight. Everyone's missing. Radiant scanned perfectly in IGV's movement. And SC goes home.
They need to be able to get wards down in this jungle, though. Like, they aren't able to kill the Alchemist, but still, you want to kill him at least, I would say, one time before the Radiance comes out would be pretty nice for them.
Well, if it's possible, right now SC's not giving him the opportunity. It's U9 who's getting the space up on top lane. He's actually approaching the Tier 2 tower while IGV are approaching their tier 2 tower. And directly into Lincoln Sphere for U9. An essential item to make sure he can try and potentially survive the Batrider engagement. But Disruptor can throw a spanner into that works quite easily.
And Earthsphere. Earthsphere does not give any hoots about Lincolns. And you don't really want to use the defensive swap on the Weaver because you want to save it for the Alchemist. That is their only save.
Rolling Boulder. It's going to be the silence already. MKP. Oh, it's actually not KP. It's going to be Kaka. Trapped up. Was that Monkey King?
Blink has been finished. I think he did reveal on the top Observer Ward with his blink as he was blinking down from the side shot, but I don't think they were actually looking at it because of this fight that was brewing in the middle lane.
Well, that Tier 2 tower still taking a bit of a beating. IGV are going to ping it out for a bit of a second, but SC able to defend behind his own Tier 2. Relative safety, and thanks to that Observer Ward sitting in the mid-river, they are seeing a lot of the movements of IGV. And in fact, in July, picking up that invis room was also scouted out. So they try, block, Sentry Ward down, and they actually reveal the Observer Ward that's there by doing so. So no potential ganking of in July getting aggressive under the invis rune.
And in July was very scared because he doesn't know where the Ventral Spirit is. KP and Faith are both in a really good spot, like sitting behind the Alchemist, but still out of vision of the potential Observer Ward that was down there. But stacks will be stolen. Sakata not really strong enough to take this out.
No, he's backing up. The Healing Ward couldn't give enough regeneration for him to stay healthy enough that he'd be able to survive a gank from Newbie. And Newbie are enjoying the time. Weaver again, still having a lot of space up on top. The Alchemist was farming up the mid. It won't have been the fastest flash farming you've seen from an Alchemist, but now he gets a little bit of space. They move back out again. A lot of that aggressive warding of IG Vitality, it doesn't exist anymore. They've switched to one defensive ward up on the top lane, and everything else looks pretty dark for him.
So this is the game we're trying to hunt the Alchemist down, and IGV are not successful. So we haven't seen any deaths yet on SCCC. He's been really good about using his scans and playing around his team, sitting in front of the Venge. So now they need to identify alternative targets. I think that they could, like, feign maneuvers, like maybe pretend they're sitting behind the Timbersaw, but actually go for the Weaver. The Weaver is very, very easy to kill. Maybe they're not comfortable without the Blink Dagger on dogfights, but I think they need to set up the Earth Spirit to get kills on the Weaver so that Weaver also doesn't become an issue, because it already seems like Alchemist is going to be a problem.
Well, they're grouping up, coming in from the Dire Shrine, so it's going to be a smoke gang from IGV. Try and find that opening, but who's the closest? Right now is the Vengeful Spirit. Faith just running through the mid lane. Chakram flies forward, and Faith already feeling spooked. So the Blink Lasso able to connect, and that's one very dead Vengeful Spirit. No way to swap herself out of that. So they just accept the fate. No one else is nearby. They're checking the Ancients, checking everywhere else, but right now it's Monkey King pushing the bottom lane. And Weaver sitting behind the tier 2 tower in mid with the rest of the team.
A smoke for Vengekill. Radiant have to be happy about that. However, IGV will...
It's tower as well.
Yeah, I don't know how they fight against this. Looks like Kaka's actually going to come from behind. He TP to the shrine. Is he going to be able to get a good...
He should be able to pounce in through the rear. There's no observer ward to watch this maneuvering. But you can see Super. It's like he feels something is coming. But now, into the Wukong's command. Where's the extra support? Able to get the stuns, but a quick Omni Slash destroys the Monkey King. They want more damage. But Sakata, okay, maybe with that disruption, silence is going to be difficult to move through. But Dogfights mowed down, super into the tree lines. U9 has a time lapse off a lot of that damage done by Paparazzi. But KP with a Blink Dagger jumping forward on top of the Juggernaut. It should be enough. Sakata will go down. U9 will have the double kill and leave Paparazzi to timber chain himself back to relative safety underneath the T1 tower. But Concoction flies forward. KP just leaves the amplification up. They're not going to push any further than this. It's just a good fight for Newbie.
That was a really smart play from Kaga. Yeah, it was a very selfless play. He knows he's going to die. They have so many ways to cut down the trees, and their attention was just way too much focus on to the Monkey King. Disruptor wasn't able to drop a good ulti off because Newbie were able to sweep around from the sides, and U9, the big pickoff there. That's going to pave the way for his Lincoln Sphere.
Yeah, really close to it. After farming up this top lane, he'll have it. And then maybe he'll feel a little bit more confident to be that frontliner. Same thing for the Alchemist. You'll see more items coming his way. SC has that armlet plus the Radiance encroaching onto the Manta style.
It's one of your worries about IGV, though, is that they just completely avoid you. And then the time lapse is one of the best counters against Lasso. And if Alchemist gets really big, do they have enough damage to kill him? Eventually, I think they should be able to.
Oh, right, that jump forward actually going in on the Alchemist. There's going to be double negative armor. Dogfire's trying to create a little bit more trouble. And the storm is perfect, but the Flame Break pushes them outside of the circle. And the bigger circle is the Wukong's command, created by Kaka. IG Vitality will take the battle towards the north, but with the Lasso, Ezzy is quite happy to go along for the ride. It's already three kills going the way of Newbie. And Paparazzi, very visible. Now he'll actually get. Okay, maybe with the amplification coming refreshed. SC still happy to fight underneath the shrine. They've already managed to survive through the regeneration with a follow-up stun. Paparazzi pushed down, but Kaka slaps him in. Dogfights turns on the magnetizer to Flame Break. Is there enough tick damage? Dogfights will fall, but how many will join him in the afterlife in July? Still trying to Firefly up and around. You got Paparazzi back into the fight too. Thanks to those Bloodstone charges, it was a low death timer. SC glimpsed out of range of the tower. He can't toggle through that. 50 seconds for him on the sideline. Caught way too deep under the tier 2.
Dang, how many heroes did they lose that fight? It looks like I don't know how long this fight recap lasted, but it wasn't long enough. It was not long enough. I think there were so many deaths on the side of IG Vitality. Only 400 gold for an outkill. That is not that much.
Paparazzi also drops down to 11 Bloodstone charges. I believe he had 18 before that fight began, if I read it correctly. But now he's down to 11.
It's tough. They all just scrambled to try and save him and ended up knocking people out of the kinetic field. Not your ideal situation.
Let's have a quick look at it again. So there's the initial start to all of this. It was the start onto the Timbersaw.
No one inside the Static Storm, and they're forced to run away because of the Monkey King ult, despite him having zero items, and SCCC just... Without the Timbersaw there to actually do damage to him, there's just not enough burst. As Juggernaut, you definitely don't want to Omni Slash him. Not when he's at full HP, he'll just regen it all back up quite easily. But it doesn't seem like they've gotten enough mileage out of like the Batrider, let's say. He had a smoke gank onto Avenge. They've only had one death on SCCC, and that was only because of a buyback on the Disruptor.
So what do they change up now? Do you look still to Injuli to be that initiator? Isolate the one person so Omni Slash is useful?
I'm not sure. If they siege, then Newbie can fight them at this point because Alchemist is big enough. And if they try and split farm, then Alchemist is going to farm faster than them. Mm-hmm. Their Roshan is not particularly good. They don't have any minus armor. Timbersaw is okay at it, but he can just tank it. They can't actually take it out quickly.
With all those options, all you're basically saying is IGV have to push and take the fights.
Well, I'm trying to look at the least terrible option that they have. That's generally something we have to do. The lesser of multiple evils.
Well, taking out the outside towns is one way to get the money and not fall behind. Restrict the area, get the vision up and running, and let Injulai do his work.
But now they're losing teamfights versus Elk, so if they try and control, like, let's say, this area of the jungle, Newbie can take a fight.
Well, the Bounty Rune sitting on top of a tree doesn't look right. He'll actually fall down thanks to Injulai with a perfect Firefly, and that's one very dead Monkey King.
Good old gold there. Net worth only looks like 1,500 in favor of Newbie. Newbie on the flip side, like if IG Vitality push bottom, they can just take Roche super easily. Slardar plus any one of their other heroes. Venge is really good. Alchemist was really good.
In July, that Invis rune scouts out Faith. U9 sitting right behind him, but in July starts the attack. So with the lasso back, I think you're going to say very goodbye to that Vengeful Spirit. No real way to save him from this. And in fact, you're going to add the extra silence from the Earth Spirit.
I think IG Vitality is like always settling. It's like, I guess we're going to go for the Vengeful Spirit kill. I guess we have to.
Well, if they waited half a second, they would have seen the Weaver. But that's a lot more of a difficult kill.
You can't go on Weaver. You swap out, sacrifice, then you end up getting the Venge anyways.
Yep.
So it was like, okay, let's take the easy route.
Maybe bottom lane they can find Slaughter. Like, KP was pretty close towards the tower, but now the Alchemist illusions come in, and Sakata has to deal with just counter-pushing the lane. Mr. Diffusal and Manta style. No quick and simple way to get through these illusions of the Alchemist.
SCCC actually wants to fight quite early too, so after Manta and Radiance, he's going for the Black King bar over the Octarine. So I kind of like this hybrid from the Alchemist. It's not like a full committal to like Roshan plus whatever. Oh yeah, I mean, Roshan is super easy for them.
It's dangerous because they smoked on top of the Dire Observer Ward.
They have Monkey King ulti too, so it's not that bad. They have what, 1, 2, 3, 4 minus armor?
yeah, okay, there is no danger.
Yeah, especially with Alka Illusion scouting outside, there's no real way for IG Vitality.
They'll have the trade-off, which would be the bottom tier 2 tower, so it gives you more Roshan for Newbie. But IG Vitality will take out the second last remaining out of tower of Newbie.
So how do you deal with an Alchemist that gets this big?
Do you just control the farm areas? Wait till he goes off by himself and gank him?
Venge is almost always sitting behind them, and they also don't have that many smokes. The Alchemist just span out their illusions, and it's very difficult to gank them. And it looks like Kaka's in front of them right now in case they do try and smoke gank. He's like, okay, yeah, we'll just lose Kaka. They smoke from the east side or the south side, and then Alchemist is going to get out of there too.
They're all TPing out. The Observer Ward's going to be now, yeah, okay, it gets his first little bit of a vision of Juggernaut moving into the Radiant Jungle. But it may also be gem time sometime soon. If Newbie want to try and establish just complete vision control on IGV.
I don't know who would hold it, though. I guess the Weaver can hold the gem. I think IG Vitality actually need a gem for the Observer Wards because they're not able to shut down the Alk through ganks at all, so they actually maybe need to make them feel scared through lack of vision, perhaps. There's only one Observer Ward on the map right now. I guess two if you count Kaka himself. He's an Observer Ward.
Observer Ward that can cleverly disguise himself as anything he wants to be. He's a pretender.
BKB ready to fight. Their anti-BKB is just Jug, actually. And he went Manta Diffusal. Diffusal not particularly
and
useful.
And now he picked up the Basher, which is coming on the courier.
Basher is good if you're worried about heroes taking down or using their defensive cooldowns, which is very good versus the Weaver, let's say.
Is he going? He's going these like these half items. Okay, half items. Like
wait, where's the Basher?
I believe it's on the courier.
Okay.
Flying in. Nice. Yep. Skull Basher in for the Juggernaut now. And but the next thing is quick buy is the Skadi. So no desire to finish up the Abyssal Blade fully just yet, Paparazzi. Well, if he really feels an opportunity to fight,
You know, Timber Chain himself in, but U9 just focuses on Super on the back line. So much damage, you get the Storm down, but they have enough damage to actually kill him off. The Bash is dead, the Link is bit triggered, but U9 gets the time lapse out, and now the Wukong Command. It surrounds IG Vitality, Papa Runs trying to cut through the trees, but he is not that quick of a chop, chop, chop. As the kick comes through, two dogfights can't create enough space. Paparazzi, there's your stun from KB, holding him in position. Omnicide goes onto the Slaughter, he'll fall down as well, but now you've got him stranded. IG, they are trying to back out to their tier 2 tower, but the pounce forward, Kaka going for the jump. He can't get the extra stun, however, not while U9 and SC are trapped at the tier 2 tower. SC will protect himself from his own concoction, and then they will take that tier 1 tower in the mid.
They were kind of close to getting the Aegis. That's about the only great thing I can say about IG Vitality in that fight. And Monkey King already had a Basher, and Timbersaw could not move inside the Wukong Command. That is a very big issue, because if you can't kill the Monkey King, you're forced to run away. And if you can't run away, you're going to lose the fight. So how do they actually fight under this very, very strong ultimate?
That's a good question. Lotus Orb doesn't protect you from that. Neither does Shiva's God.
Neither does Armor, neither does BKB.
So the only thing you could potentially do is what, push him out of his own Wukong Command?
Ideally, or just kill him really quickly.
That would be the bigger thing, but Juggernaut never really found the opening on him. And losing the Disruptor, you lost your big teamfight controller. But they group up now on the bottom lane. That Storm is back up for Disruptor. You do not have the Omnislash, another 45 seconds. And Magnetize also being on cooldown may not be the greatest fight that IG Vitality ever wanted, but Paparazzi is not stopping him, he's going in. Alchemist TP'd out towards the mid lane, and the rest of Newbie understand without the Alchemist, they really don't want to have this fight. Faith, he doesn't get hit by the Shiva's Guard, so Paparazzi, they swap and into the blink. One way to get away, Faith understood it, so did KP. Nice synergy of escape.
Super's not even close to Glimpse. They want to fight so badly right now, but they just can't. There's nowhere to force. If they try and force high ground, they just lose out because of the shrines and Alchemist illusions. The T2 on the left side, it's not really worth it for them. It doesn't really open anything up. And then what other options do they have? Go for Roche. Roche is already dead. Try and farm. You're farming versus Alchemist. So their options are just severely limited. They've blown through so many smokes with hardly yielding anything more than eventual spirit kill. And IG Vitality are hard.
Oh, they're going to be the ones to find the gank. In July, was just trying to Firefly and push his wave quickly. Now Unstable Concoction goes his way. Support's going to be there with the extra stun. They can't just blink in thanks to Firefly that was down, but it won't matter when Batrider is dead. 50 seconds on the sideline. That's basically a guaranteed tier 2 tower, especially considering his life.
Ooh, Batrider is actually going for a Scepter. I don't see that too often.
Maybe they're just feeling he needs so much more control than what he currently offers.
It's like, I want more than just a Venge kill. I want plus one if anyone's standing close enough. The radius is not that large, though. It's the only downside about the Scepter. And I mean, it's pretty decent here. Even if he goes BKB, he still dies to the mass armor. If he goes armor, you'll tank anything, but you won't be able to kill anyone. Scepter, it gives him more survivability. And
that concoction's brewing. Paparazzi, real trouble for him. Lotus Orb's going to actually return it, but the Wukong Command makes it, again, difficult for Timbersaw to get back out of, especially when the crush from KP cancels it off. So Paparazzi is now down for 50 seconds. Again, another big window of opportunity for Newbie.
So sad, 5 Bloodstone charges.
Considering he was shy of 20 before and now he's down to 5, yeah, this game has changed for the Timbersaw. Laning phase was the dream, and now this is becoming the nightmare. Radiant's
middle tower just can't catch anyone. And now he'll finally transition out of the BOTs. I would say he got enough value out of his phase boots.
And then he can start building Aghanim Scepters for the rest of his team.
Yes. They actually don't have amazing axe. But Slaughter doesn't have one. Vengeance is pretty good.
The Weaver one is the
Weaver
one I'm thinking
one
of.
Is awesome. But Alka hasn't actually even been close to dying in a lot of these fights.
Yep.
So they actually seem like they want to kill the Weaver first, in which case the axe is not extremely useful. You get more survivability, but you don't actually get too much benefit from casting on other people. But it will be very useful for the high ground siege. And then I would say you just get 2 eggs and then just dump moon shards into people.
Just let Alchemist down the front lines, hit the tower, and then just time ups him out when IG Vitality do the damage.
Yeah, there's no risk.
Yep.
Very little risk. Unless they jump the Venge. But if they jump the Venge, then you can just time lapse and then you still have the defensive swap.
Yep.
So they have like a, you know, kind of 3-way saving going on.
Vitality poking around the pit. Roshan's not going to be out for a little bit longer, and the crotch into a Wukong command. Okay, that's a very dead Earth Spirit. And actually standing inside the Wukong command. Okay, Nerk pouncing out. KP's in trouble. The lasso holding the slaughter in position. Monkey King has already left, so KP's left to just fend for himself, and only can't really do that. Crushes the wave, but he knows he's dead.
Wow, he used Midas and he bought his force that right before. That's some value. Look at his gold. Oh my goodness, 44 gold. All reliable, I guess. But he, that's some good stuff.
Efficiency rating. So just under a minute until Roshan is up. IG Vitality really need to look towards that. If we're already talking about the issues of what's happening with the survivability of Nubi, if they do start to high ground siege with the Alchemist, adding an Aegis the Immortal to this is more and more issues. And as he's going to restrict the map now, push the bottom lane. IG Vitality will not be looking to fight without the lasso.
Yeah, with lasso on cooldown, they pretty much have almost no hope of saving this tower.
Weaver's in really deep. He's actually sitting on top of IGV at the moment. U9 looking for the kill onto the disruptor. The bottom tier 1 tower is being chipped away. But it's not dead just yet, so it could be another denial here if Paparazzi wants to get rid of it. And in fact, they will do so.
Any other avenue for IGV to come back? I'm trying to think what is the best thing for them to do right now. How do they actually get back in this game?
It seems like the clearance and the push as well. Like, you got this single target against the Alchemist, which is there from IGV, but they can't. Like, even when the Mana Stalk gets triggered, Juggernaut doesn't do enough damage with his Omni Slash.
Yeah, he doesn't do enough damage because he has Scotty. Scotty's better if you want to live and continue to scale.
Mm-hmm.
And it's decent for BKB because you can actually keep chasing people, but one of the downsides is you just don't have enough damage. So
unless that turns into a kite game, but if that Aghanim does go to the Weaver, then there is no kite game.
Yeah. I think they have to play actually for the super long game.
Weaver's actually going in for a BKB now, so already has the Lincolns. Going into a BKB, has the casual Orchid, that's what he silenced up the Disruptor with on the bottom lane previously. And Alchemist is actually not going to go for the Aghanim Scepter, he's got the full Assault Cuirass in his quick buy.
Yeah, but he's not dying during BKB. It's really good for high ground siege too. So they can end the game, I would say, potentially with that and maybe an
Axe. That Observer Sword in July, I believe. It's a little bit further up towards the north. But you can see the line is being drawn by Monkey King. Wrap around and come from the northeast. IGV won't really be expecting to come from behind. And maybe Sakata. No, the blink fall. He's able to get the spin to the crush. Won't have its effect for the Wukong command. It is down. The storm is doing its work. But Disruptor pops to U9's Orchid. And Paparazzi's on the run. The Lotus Orb will reflect the concoction back up again. But BKB will protect. And now it's Dogfights who's stuck on the front lines. Being attacked by U9. That'll be his double kill. Omni Slash going out. Kaka cops the brunt of most of it. U9 the tail end of it. But on the front line, there's your lasso. Hold him there for the swap out. Etsy's back in a fighting position. And Paparazzi again. Timber chains up. He actually does manage to launch the chain, but U9's not giving up just yet. Diffuser Blade holding in July in position to allow for his triple kill. And they look for the ultra, or for the quad at least. It's Paparazzi stunned up. He can't get away. SC will take it. And Invictus Gaming, four heroes down, none with buyback, and no way to contest Roshan, which will be the next objective here for Nubi.
Does a really good smoke ink, and Juggernaut had very fast reflexes there. Sakata was able to spin away before he was hit by the Boundless Strike. It could have been even worse for IG Vitality there, but they just have no solution to the Alchemist. Their team fight is just absolutely atrocious. And he has the Shadow Blade on the Monkey King, so Monkey King was able to just invis, and they cannot stop his ultimate. He's just sitting there.
Terrific fight for Nubi. And it really does feel Alchemist has already done it once before. You stay behind, but you understand how you can just pull yourself back into this game. KP with fantastic stuns. And they just chain him off. They don't even care if they take it themselves while the BKB immunity is up. U9 has freedom. The punching bag can be SC, but there's so much save. It's difficult for IGV to really target prioritize at all in these fights. And who do actually, it will be the Aghanim Scepter over on the Weaver.
They can potentially end the game pretty soon. If the game goes super late, like 55, 60 plus minutes, I think IGV can start to turn things in their favor.
Can they delay it though?
I don't know. But if it theoretically gets to that point, Alchemist is actually going to have slot issues because there's a couple heroes that are just not that great with the Moon Shard.
Mm-hmm.
And there's only two ags that he can give to that actually benefit a hero's ultimate.
Everything else will only be stats on Moonshot. Yep.
Yeah, so you gotta think about going 60 plus if you're IGV.
That's
when you're gonna win, if you're gonna win.
So then it's defend, it's the Aghanim Scepter for Timbersaw, double Chakrams, keep the waves out, clean up the tree lines if that's what it has to be, leave the Chakrams up, and then just cut the tree lines on the side so Newbie have less options pushing into the base.
Yeah, I think they're going to push base right now, though, with the Aegis and with the freshly completed Ags. Mm-hmm. Alchemist, this is the strongest that you get. Everything is fairly marginal at this point. I guess Ags on Ventral Spear is pretty good, but it's marginal after that. And the gold lead is very favorable for the 20k.
Just shy of it. But Newbie, they're still having issues with Paparazzi cutting the creep wave in the mid, and he is, like, Aghanim Scepter is on the wish list. Yeah. SC now the best support, buying up mass obs and sentry wards for his team.
Too much gold. Keep buying those gems, tomes, everything else.
Well, he could buy the entire Assault Cuirass at the moment. He just won't have buyback if he does it. So, yeah, it was a Shadowblade coming in.
I don't actually think he needs buyback. I guess they've been playing pretty safely, though, with the first, like, the phase boost pickups, early BKB pickups. Like, they've been playing pretty safe, so I would actually be surprised if he did not have buyback money. Let's see, he's at the secret shop right now. So, full AC with buyback.
Yep.
And gem.
Just short by 400 now, he bought the gem. But hey, there's the money up on top lane, walking towards him. And it's actually over next to the Observer Ward down bottom lane. You can see that hunting coming in. If they can just reach him. Kaka as well as U9 having a lot of vision around here. And they mostly, the two Observer Wards IGV committed, they're both watching around the Ancient / Secret Shop area of Newbie. So they don't really see that much of this maneuver as Newbie look to try and push the high ground. And once that Gem of True Sight's on the front lines too, I think they also understand there is no keeping vision here. They lose their last remaining out of tower. And IGV, this is the testing point. Can they defend? Can they keep Newbie away from their tier 3 tower? Right now, SC is taking a little bit of the damage. Karka's stun's gonna miss. They forced off SC in DP. He'll trigger the BKB and just runs after Super. Gets a quick stun. They'll have to shrine up nice and quickly as well. That tier 3 tower being chipped away. Unai and SC doing the work. Fortification is the only thing that really stopped them. They glimpse him back into the storm. They can hold him there. The time lapse doesn't pull him out of the storm. It was a little bit too early for it. Now the Wukong, come on, create a little bit of space. Same with the VS swap. It will keep SC alive. Even the bash stun. Sakata can't get the easiest run here, but no one dies for now, including the tier 3 tower.
They can easily have Unai hit the tower. He still has Aegis for a minute, I would say, maybe like 55 seconds.
And then SC back in to do it. Flamebreak can push him around. SC not a healthy man, but KP with the crush. They hold the Juggernaut there. Secondary stun, lasso. All right, that's one way to do it. Pull SC so far in. He's on top of the tower, but again, another time lapse. Pulls him back into the world of safety. And a Bloodthorn. Oh, that's real trouble. Paparazzi, there's no way you can survive levels of that damage. And this is mid-ranks. No way to stop it. And I'm wondering now, even with the buyback from the Timbersaw, if IGV can stop this destruction of Newbie. About to try something in July. No lasso. The kick gonna miss his target. SC still focusing on the rack, still taking it for the team. The Lotus Orbs let the stuns go, but they found their target. They found the Batrider in the tree lines. Buyback is available for him, and it's all or nothing. In fact, in July, doesn't even buy back. He calls it right here, right now. Shy of the 40-minute mark, Newbie will take game one.
Easy, easy out game. Forced the other team to move into your jungle. They read them like a book. It's very easy to sense out those smokings from SCCC and the rest of the team.